Good morning. Thank you for joining us for our Marian celebration. We come together this morning to celebrate Mary, the Mother of God. The month of May is dedicated to Mary. As we pray the rosary together, let us ask that through her intercession, our community continues to be blessed and protected in all that we do.
Please remain seated for the crowning of Mary.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of death. Amen. Gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. You were chosen by the Father, you were chosen for the Son. Peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. Blessed are you among women, blessed in turn, O women too. Blessed blessed they with gentle hearts, gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright, gentle mother. Peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love, teach us wisdom, teach us love.
It is truly fitting, Mary, that we honor you. God chose you to be his mother. The prophets of old spoke of you with praise. The angels bowed in reverence to you. All generations call you blessed. So joyfully, Mary, we praise you. Amen.
O Mary, you received the word of the Father in your immaculate heart. He became the fruit of your womb and the child you cared for. We pray you continue to care for our church as you have from its beginning. My soul proclaims the Lord. My spirit sings his praises. He looks on me, he lifts me up, and gladness fills my days. O Mary, your life was a pilgrim of faith, filled with hope for things to come. You fill us with inspiration because you trusted that the Lord's words to you would be fulfilled. All nations now will share my joy. His gifts he has outpoured, his little one he has made great. I magnify the Lord.
O Mary, you accepted God's loving plan of salvation as you stood by your Son on Calvary. You became the mother of all people who receive life through the death of your Son. For those who love his holy name, his mercy will not die. His strong right arm puts down the proud and lifts the lowly high. O Mary, you joined in prayer with the apostles as together you waited the coming of the Spirit. You became the perfect model of the church at prayer. He fills the hungry with good things, the rich he sends away. The promise made to Abraham is filled to endless day.
O Mary, you were raised to the glory of heaven, and you care for the pilgrim church with the mother's love. You care for the church throughout history until the Lord comes in glory. O Mary, let us praise you. Give us strength to make our minds one in truth and our hearts one in love for you and your Son. Loving Heart of Mary, be our refuge in times of need and our hope in times of trial. O Mary, Mother of God, we turn to you for protection. Holy Mother of God, listen to our prayers. Keep us safe from every danger and help us to be worthy of the promises of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
The Luminous Mysteries. The Luminous Mysteries begin with the baptism of Jesus in the Jordan River by John the Baptist. From then on, Jesus began to do great things. In the second Luminous Mystery, we go to Cana in Galilee, where Jesus turned water into wine so that the people could have a good time. Mary said, "Do whatever Jesus tells you." The third Luminous Mystery calls us to go with Jesus through the towns and cities of his own country. The light of his love shone on everyone he met, especially the poor and the sick and those that others looked down on.
On one of those journeys, Jesus led his friends up a high mountain. They saw him shining in light, and he promised they would share his light too. This mystery is called the Transfiguration. Just before he died, Jesus had supper with his friends, and he gave himself to them in bread and wine. "This is my body," he said. "This is my blood." In the fifth Luminous Mystery, we remember the Holy Eucharist. How wonderful to follow Jesus in the Luminous Mysteries. We are baptized too, and God wants us to do great things. We can bring joy to people like Jesus did, especially to those that others look down on. This is a beautiful world. Let us always see it lit with the beauty God gave it. Let us always go to supper with Jesus and receive him in the signs of the Eucharist. The Luminous Mysteries remind us to follow Jesus, the light of the world.
Let us pray the Luminous Mysteries of the Rosary, asking our Blessed Mother's intercessions for peace and justice throughout the world. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, a communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, it is now, and shall be.
The first luminous mystery, the baptism of Jesus. A reflection from St. Pope John Paul II. The baptism of Jesus in the Jordan is first of all a mystery of light. Christ descends into the waters, and the heavens open up wide, and the voice of the Father declares him the beloved Son. The Spirit descends on him to give him the mission he is to carry out.
A reading from the Gospel of Matthew. Then Jesus came from Galilee to John at the Jordan River to be baptized. John tried to prevent him, saying, "I need to be baptized by you, and yet you are coming to me." Jesus replied, "Allow it now, for thus it is fitting for us to fulfill all righteousness." Then he was baptized. After Jesus was baptized, he came up from the water, and behold, the heavens were open, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove, coming upon them. A voice came from the heavens saying, "This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased."
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
The second luminous mystery, the wedding of Cana, a reflection from St. Pope John Paul II. Another mystery of light is the first of the miracles given at Cana, when Christ changes water into wine and opens the hearts of the disciples to faith. He is able to do this thanks to the intervention of Mary, his mother, the first among the believers.
A reading from the Gospel of John. On the third day, there was a wedding in Cana, in Galilee. And the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus and his disciples were also invited to the wedding. When the wine ran short, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." Jesus said to her, "Woman, how does this affect me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servers, "Do whatever he tells you." Now there were 6 stone water jars. They were for Jewish ceremonial washings, each holding 20 to 30 gallons. Jesus told them, "Fill the jars with water to the brim." So they filled them to the brim. Then he told them, "Draw some out now and take it to the head waiter." So they took it. When the head waiter tasted the water that had become wine, he called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves good wine first, and then, when people have drunk freely, an inferior one. You have kept the wine good until now." Jesus did this as the beginning of his signs in Cana and Galilee, and so revealed his glory. His disciples began to believe in him.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Thank you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
The third luminous mystery, the proclamation of the kingdom of God, a reflection from St. Pope John Paul II. Another mystery of light is the preaching by which Jesus proclaims the coming of the kingdom of God. He calls us to conversion and forgives the sins of all who come to him. This begins the ministry of mercy, which will continue until the end of the world, particularly in the sacrament of reconciliation.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke. He came to Nazareth, where he had grown up, and went according to his custom, into the synagogue on the day of Sabbath. He stood up to read and was handed a scroll of the prophet Isaiah. He unrolled the scroll and found the passage where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to captives and recovery of sight to the blind. He has sent me to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord." Rolling up the scroll, he handed it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all in the synagogue looked intently at him. He said to them, "Today this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing."
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Thank you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The fourth luminous mystery, the Transfiguration, a reflection from St. Pope John Paul II. The height of the mysteries of light is the Transfiguration, believed to have taken place on Mount Tabor. The glory of God shines forth from the face of Christ, as the Father commands the astonished apostles to listen to him. As well, the Father asked the apostles to prepare the experience with him the agony of the Passion, so they can come with him to the joy of the resurrection and a new life transfigured by the Holy Spirit.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke. Jesus took Peter, John, and James and went up the mountain to pray. While he was praying, his face changed in appearance and his clothes became dazzling white. Behold, two men were conversing with him, Moses and Elijah. They spoke of his exodus and what he would accomplish in Jerusalem. Peter and his companions had been overcome by sleep, but becoming fully awake, they saw his glory and the two men standing with him. As they were about to part from him, Peter said to Jesus, "Master, it is good that we are here. Let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." While he was speaking, a cloud came and cast a shadow over them. They became frightened. Then from the cloud came a voice that said, "This is my son. Listen to him." After the voice had spoken, Jesus was found alone. They fell silent and did not tell anyone what they had seen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Thank you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
The fourth luminous mystery, the Transfiguration, a reflection from St. Pope John Paul II. A final mystery of light is the institution of the Eucharist, in which Christ offers his body and blood as food under the signs of bread and wine. He assures us of his love for humanity and offers himself in sacrifice for the salvation of the world.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke. He said to them, I have eagerly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. I tell you I shall not eat it again until there's fulfillment in the kingdom of God. Then he took a cup, gave thanks, and said, take this and share it among yourselves. For I tell you that from this time on, I shall not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes. Then he took bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to them, saying, this is my body which will be given for you. Do this in memory of me. Likewise, he took the cup after they had eaten, saying, this is the cup of the new covenant in my blood, which will be shed for you.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses.
Thank you. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious advocate, thine eyes of mercy toward us. And after this, our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
Please stand for our closing song. Thank you for joining us today for our May Crowning event. At this time, we're going to have our second graders please sit down and our eighth graders please sit down. We're going to hold you guys and we're going to take some pictures. And at this time, can I have our third graders silently return back to class and our fifth graders silently return back to class as well?